Hello and welcome to RC Autopsy. This is a little video series I do where I look at my broken RC parts and try to answer three questions. Them being, what is actually wrong, what's actually broken, can I fix it, and is it worth fixing? So today we're going to be looking at some bearings. These are some that I took out of my Tamiya Lunchbox recently when I rebuilt it. And these are completely seized. Some of them don't move at all. No movement in that bearing at all. Some of them have, like that one, there's a little bit of play but then it stops. It does move a little bit but then it stops. But some of them are completely seized up. See, that one spins all the way but it's really rough. So I've kind of got three stages there. I've got a metal sealed one here. My understanding is that metal sealed ones you can't really rebuild, you can't really fix. See, that one's just running really rough, not particularly smooth. And got one here, let's look with this one. That's got a little bit of play but then stops. So we're going to leave the metal sealed ones because I don't think you can actually take those apart and fix them. I think they're sort of a more, if you're running on road, not in dirty conditions, you run metal sealed bearings because they're generally not going to fail on you, but they're not sort of dirty, wet conditions. Not going to rebuild that, that's just going to get thrown away. But yeah, these rubber sealed ones, we've got three stages here. We've got one that's completely locked up, we've got one with a little bit of play in, a little bit of movement, and we've got one that moves completely but is really rough. So we're going to open them up and see what's wrong inside. So I'm going to start with the one that spins all the way around and is quite free but is really rough. So you can see on both sides there's a rubber seal and that protects the little ball bearings inside. To a certain degree, obviously there's going to be muck and stuff getting into that rubber seal. I'm going to try and take this apart. I'm going to use three tools. Got some little tweezers, some tiny little tweezers, and we've got two sort of pick tools just here. So I'm going to try and get this rubber seal off. I've never actually done this before, so I have no idea how you do it. I may have to go off camera and do this, you never know. But the idea is just try and pierce that or get that rubber seal out so you can access the little ball bearings inside. I'm not quite sure how you do it. I might go with a thinner pick tool. Here, what might be better? Maybe if we got, let's try a craft knife because it's actually much thinner, might be able to go down the side of it. There we go. Slide that, there we go, that's it. So get a craft knife, that's a much better way of doing it. Just get a blade, just run that down there. So we need something to put that on. Now these bearings could probably have already got grease inside, and then I used the wheel bearing grease. I've got wheel bearing grease and I shove that all the way around the bearings just to protect them from water and dirt. So let's see if the camera's going to pick this up. You can see in there it's quite gross. There's a lot, it's all brown. Yeah, it's all brown. It's got grease in there, which is good, but it's not a particularly good colour. It's more of like a rusty colour. Yeah, not particularly pleasant. So I'll take off the other side. Now this side's not coming out. Ah, there we go, I got it. So that's the other side. I can actually see the balls in there, which is quite nice. You just see them in there. So that's the one that actually moves quite freely. So let me just give it a quick wipe over so I'm not getting dirt everywhere. So this one does move, but it's just really rough. So it to spin. You can actually see there's quite a lot of play in there, which means that some of the balls may have worn down, so there's probably quite a lot of rust in there. So that's the first one, that's the one that moves. So let me open all the others up and we'll see what they're like inside. So this is the one that was moving but had a was getting caught on something, was just stopping, and it's actually moving freely now all the way. It's still a bit, it's a bit very notchy though, very notchy. And then this is the one that's completely locked up, that's got no movement in it at all. So there is actually green grease in there, which is nice to see, but I think one of the metal balls in there has completely rusted to the or both sides of the actual bearing. So yeah, that's what's inside a bearing. You've got, in these ones, they're not balls all the way round. There's holders for the actual balls to sit in, what it looks like. Let's see if I can actually clean one out and show you. Just with this towel, just get this grease out of here. So there's like a little, there's a ball there, and there's like a little spacer, a holder, that doesn't touch this inner part, and then there's another ball there, and then there's another spacer, and then there's another ball, and it does that all the way around. So in total there's eight little balls in there, and they obviously spin and rotate in sort of the pre-lubricated oil that's already in there. Keeps focusing on the wrong thing. Those balls are contained within that outer and inner ring, and they spin around, and that spins the whole thing. So yeah, so probably one of those balls has rusted to both sides, and that's why it's not moving. It's all seized up. So that's what's inside these bearings. So it's nice to see grease in there, but it's not a very good colour for grease. So, to answer the other two questions, can I fix these bearings? Yes, I probably could. Probably take a bit of WD-40 or something like that just to get rid of all the grease inside, and then maybe some rust converter to actually convert the rust back into metal. Give it a really good scrub just to get rid of all the dirt and debris that's in there, and then give it another blast of WD-40, let it dry, give it a good clean, and then put some more oil in there. Put the seal back on, provided that you haven't actually damaged the seal. Some of these are a bit mangled. Just by me taking them out. So if those seals are in good condition, you can put them back on, and then you should have a working bearing, which is quite nice. So if you've got, this leads on to my other question, is it worth doing? These bearings were really cheap. These were from the Lunchbox. There's only 10 bearings roughly in the Lunchbox, and they were about £4 or £5 off eBay for 10 bearings. So in my eyes, it's not really worth saving, especially one that's completely locked up, like, I think it's that one, yeah, that one. This one's completely locked up, who knows what kind of damage has been done inside, and how much effort it's going to take to get back to a good condition again. There's probably going to be flat spots on the bearings and all that sort of stuff, so it's probably just worth throwing away and getting a new bearing. Now, if you do want to see me rebuild and get one of these bearings working again, probably this one, because it's completely locked up and it's going to give the best demonstration of it. Let me know in the comments down below and I'll try and get it working again. But in my eyes, they're not worth saving. They're so cheap and there's so many of them about, so many kits about. It's just better to get a brand new kit and just replace it and throw this one away. Even if you did clean it up completely, get all the rust off it, it's still going to rust again. You can never completely get rid of rust, and it's just going to come back and have the same issue. So in my eyes, not worth saving, just throw them away, get new ones. But yeah, if you do want to see a video of me clean and get this bearing running again, let me know in the comments down below and I'll happily do that. I'll try and find the best solution, because I've got four bearings here that are in a bit of a bad shape, got this one as well, so I can try and get them working again using various methods like WD-40, just soap and water, oil and oil degreaser products, stuff like that. So if you want to see that video, let me know, and I'll post them up as soon as I can. Thanks for watching. If you want to check out the Facebook and Twitter pages, links are down below in the description box. I hope you found this video informative. All you need to do is to open up rubber sealed bearings is a knife, Stanley knife, craft knife, whatever, just to get down the side of those seals and flip it up. And that's all you need. So very easy to open them up, see what's wrong. Again, I'll reiterate this, if you want to see a video of me fixing these, getting them working again, getting them spinning freely, let me know. I'll try four different methods, being I've got four broken bearings. And we'll see what I can do. But yeah, in the meantime, thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time on RC Projects. Bye.